Remember to follow Your Thunder during the offseason on thunder.nba.com and social media to keep up with the latest draft news, summer league action, and more as the team prepares for the next season of Thunder basketball. And welcome back to Thunder Insiders. I'm now joined by Matt Pinto, the voice of the Thunder on the radio, and the second favorite Nick in the Thunder organization. You're our favorite, Nick Gallo from thunder.nba.com. Well, guys, we've already talked about this season and what it was for the Thunder, how successful they were in their sixth season here. But let's talk about what this team is going to look like next year. Obviously, there's going to be some changes in the offseason. We know that Tabo Cephalosha's contract is up, Derek Fisher, Caron Butler. This could look different next season. What do you expect, Matt?
And they also have two first-round draft picks, and we don't know how they'll utilize those. Will they, in fact, draft and have players on the roster from this draft, maybe potentially trade or draft players that they wind up having play over in Europe? So there are a lot of variables that go into the equation. And, Nick, I know that Sam Presti and his staff will be diligent in the way they go about constructing the roster for next season. But the bottom line is this team has incredible youth. It has a strong core of guys that have come through a lot of experiences together. They'll be better as a result of that and the work they get done this offseason.
Well, they also have flexibility both in terms of assets and financially. And so that's really helpful just as Sam Presti tries to figure out what this team is going to look like next year. It also helps that he has flexibility on the roster. A lot of versatile players from Kevin Durant, Russell Westbrook, Jeremy Lamb, Perry Jones. You know, guys can play multiple positions on this team, including Reggie Jackson, who, as we saw late in the season, was in the starting lineup, maybe back in a six-man role next year. But there's a lot of youth and a lot of internal development that the Thunder is looking to achieve this summer.
Well, and in the offseason, that's the time for all of these younger players and veterans to improve on what they need to individually. We sat through exit interviews and talked to several of the guys on what they hope to get better at. Matt, one of the things Jeremy Lamb talked about, wanting to be better on defense. Even Scott Brooks talked about how the assist numbers can go up. What do you expect to see from some of these guys when we come back next fall?
Well, I think individually, all of them will be focused on defense. I mean, that will be a standard across the board. They know that they've got to get better, dig in at that end of the floor, recognize that every possession is valuable, and that when they can stop teams with their athleticism and length, that's when they're at their best to get back out and transition and run right back at the opposition. But Perry Jones, I thought, was interesting, Nick, in that he said he doesn't yet know how he can incorporate his athleticism at the highest level to impact games. So I think he's got to begin to learn that this summer because he's entering his third season in the NBA. And Kevin Durant paid him the ultimate compliment, saying he's the most athletic player in the league.
Well, there are players for sure who are trying to figure out how to harness all of their gifts. And even Steven Adams is a guy who athletically and physically it can just be dominating at times. But he's still learning how to completely control all of those gifts that he has. Jeremy Lamb is another guy whose length, leaping ability, athleticism can be harnessed in different ways to manifest itself on the court in a productive way. But really, I think that the attitude is established by this team's leaders. And as we see every single year, Kevin Durant comes back with some new wrinkle in his game. Russell Westbrook said he's going to dedicate himself to the defensive end of the floor. He knows that he can be an all defensive team type player every single night if he puts his mind to it. And then, as always, Serge Ibaka, he said he was going to work on some things that were secret, but we know he's going to come back and his work ethic is through the roof.
Kevin Durant said he might incorporate a new shot. Hey, I might incorporate a few new words. Who knows? We could get better in the offseason as well. We look forward to it, of course, next year, but let's hear from the players and what they hope to accomplish in the next few months to come.
Definitely going to continue to watch film and find ways to pick and choose spots and just find a way to be aggressive, whether offensively and defensively, at all times. Trying to see the game a few more steps ahead and figure out when and when not to go. But
seeing these players, like a player that will lock you up and then go score on you, like that motivates me. So I'm definitely going to work on my defense, come back a much better defensive player. I think that will just, you know, help me as a, you know, be a whole overall player, and you know, when you disrupt on both ends of the floor, I think that's huge.
Definitely do the best I can to, you know, learn how to play with my athleticism, you know, make that work in my favor. It's something that I got used to doing, you know, because of my past, but you know, just get used to playing on my athleticism offensively and defensively. And see where it goes from there.
I'm still like definitely under them because I still got like a ton more to learn. Like, you know what I mean? I think I made a good step this year, but it's like nowhere near what I think I need to learn and get into good habits and be as smart as just to go and work out on my own. So, you know, I'm definitely going to stick around them for as much as I can and just try and get as much knowledge and, yeah, try and learn the game.
Figure out to some different type of move for Shad. I'm going to figure out to try to master. But I'm just going to overall just try to get better, work on every single part of my game, and bring it back to the team. I think I've grown as a leader as the time goes, as the season went along. I can be better next season just as I get more and more comfortable, and just continue to have fun and enjoy the game like I do.
For me, that's what I want to do, is do whatever it takes to help us win, because that's best for the team. It's also best for me. I've talked about that in the past of you need to create value for yourself as a player, and you need to be valuable to the team. You can do that in a lot of different ways. So I think I have a good understanding of the things I can do to help and try to continue to do that.
Just come back smarter, man. I think coming back smarter and more wiser is key for us. I think as a unit, you know, as players, we got all the tools to be able to do what we need to do offensively and defensively, but mentally is key for us. I think that's going to be the key for us moving forward.
Definitely got to come back in better shape and try to get back to the basketball that I played in Boston. So that's my goal.
You know, sacrifice, that's something we need to get better on for next year, where, you know, you will not have energy in offense to score 30 points, but at least you're going to have energy to give everything on defense.
Ahead on Thunder Insider.
I don't want to keep hanging our hats on us being young, because, you know, we've been through a lot so far in this league, and like you said, time is always ticking, but I like what we have, you know, guys that want to be here and play with each other.